The success of both of those businesses is predicated on how many people I help in both of those scenarios. So I'm just excited to try to get out there and help as many people as I can every day.
This is what I believe. I'm sharing that with you for nothing. Just get out there and succeed.
I feel like there is a boom coming, a real estate boom, and I could be totally wrong. It's just my opinion. And I feel like the reason is because, number one, there's no speculative buying going on. Nobody's buying houses to flip them tomorrow. Everybody buying a house is buying the house to move into. All investors buying investments are buying them to hold them. They're buying them based on the cash flow of that property right now against what they're paying for in today's market. Nobody's buying anything to flip tomorrow. There could be a few like wholesale things going on. There could be a few courthouse sales happening where people are buying and flipping. Sure, of course. But the normal retail buyer is not buying properties to flip. They're buying them to hang on to them, to live in them for 5 or 10 years. So that tells me that it's really, really tough for me to see that there's a bubble in place because everything's very solid. Everybody's really purchasing these properties based on the long term. Another thing is there's a lot of cash in the market right now. There's people hoarding cash, waiting on the market to crash. That means that a lot of people are predicting a crash to happen at some point in the future. And you know, when people are predicting it or waiting on it, that's probably the lowest possibility of it actually happening. You know, the worst crashes happen when nobody's expecting it. Right? Everybody's expecting one to happen any minute, so everybody's hanging on to cash. So if the market does go down, all that cash is gonna get dumped in the market, like what we saw in the stock market in the pandemic. And what happened? The market came right back up. It wasn't an elongated crash, it was just a blimp in the radar. That's exactly what would happen if we had another crash. There's so much cash out there. So, and interest rates are so low that people are borrowing money instead of spending their cash, which means what? They're still gonna have cash. So I think that there's a possibility the economy, you know, is going to be great next year, and that's going to make interest rates come up some. This is just my prediction. I have no idea, right? It could go so many different directions, but if I'm trying to predict, I'm going to predict that interest rates are going to come up a little bit with the economy. It's going to make people borrow more money instead of spend their cash. They're going to spend their cash instead of borrowing money because interest rates are a little higher. People are gonna become a little less cash heavy, which means there'll be less cash in the market if the market does decide to take a dip. And you know, maybe we'll see an escalation of prices, which might bring some speculative buying to the table. And if we see all that happen, then we may be in a situation where, you know, we'll see a nice rush with a nice little decline at some point. So I mean, it's gonna happen at some point, right? You know, it's gonna happen at some point, but I don't think it's gonna happen in 2021. I think 2021 is gonna be a great year for real estate appreciation, so on and so forth. I think we're gonna continue to see end users buy, people that are buying to hold. I don't think the speculative, you know, flippers are gonna come out the woodworks next year. I think we're still gonna be in an environment where it's a very healthy market, and I'm just super excited about it. So whatever comes, I'm not too worried about it either way. I'm just gonna give it everything I have to try to help as many people as I can. So you have two businesses going on. I have a real estate business where I help people buy and sell properties, and I have a real estate coaching business where I help agents figure out how to help people buy and sell properties. And so both are a service industry where I'm just, that literally the success of both of those businesses is predicated on how many people I help in both of those scenarios. So I'm just excited to try to get out there and help as many people as I can every day.